Welcome to the VEX Robotics Competition Referee Training Videos, designed for both referees and teams. This is Chapter 3, Safety and Human Interaction. Safety is our number one priority in the VEX Robotics Competition. The last thing we would ever want is for anyone to ever get hurt at one of our events. That's why the first rules in our manual are about safety. That being said, these are safe classroom robots that are designed to be handled by students. Rule S1 reminds teams that robots and team actions may not damage field elements, scoring objects, or other robots in any way. Offending robots may be disabled or disqualified, and that robot will require re-inspection before being allowed back onto the field. It's also important to note Rule G8, which states that drive team members are prohibited from making intentional contact with any scoring object, field element, or robot during a match. Rule G8B also clarifies that drive team members are prohibited from breaking the plane of the field perimeter at any time during the match. In general, human interaction with robots has been limited, so we can highlight the capabilities of the robots, their designers, and their programmers. Minor violations of this rule that do not affect the match will result in a warning. Match-affecting offenses will result in a disqualification. The only exception is G8A, which is also known as the forgot to turn your robot on rule. Rule G8A states that during the driver control period, drive team members may only touch their own robot if the robot has not moved at all during the match. So, if you forgot to plug in a battery, need to plug in a VexNet key or V5 radio, or didn't turn your robot on, you do have some leeway to fix that here. Please see your game manual for further details. Please note that during the autonomous period or programming skills matches, there is no human interaction with robots whatsoever. That means no repositioning and no turning on or off a robot during autonomous. This year's game has a few other safety considerations that we want to remind teams of as well. One of the most exciting parts of VRC Turning Point is the opportunity for teams to launch balls in order to toggle high flags. However, if you choose to engage in this aspect of Turning Point, please do so safely. Never aim a robot with a loaded ball in the direction of a human, whether on the playing field, in the classroom, or in the pits, whether it's enabled, disabled, or even turned off. Never launch a ball in a direction that you have not checked and cleared visually. Anytime that you're actively testing a mechanism which could launch balls, make sure that everyone within range is wearing safety glasses and aware of the test.
Testing! Clear!
This field also has 6 PVC posts around the edge of the field. When the field is not in use, you may want to put markers on the posts so that people don't accidentally trip over them. This can be a great use for some game objects from previous years. That's all for Chapter 3, but make sure you check out the other chapters that explore other refereeing topics.